Ma'am, am I clearly audible?
Yes, Anjali.
Thank you. Greetings, Lexiconites. I, Sansari Kapoor.
And I, Harsh Sharma.
Extend a warm welcome to you to this eagerly awaited session of Lexicons Expert Roundtable. I'm sure that each of you are well aware of the pillars of the Lexicon group, the ones who have made Lexicon a resounding success.
Heading this esteemed group, we have our remarkable visionary, S.D. Sharma Sir, the chairman of the Lexicon Group of Institutes. Sir has nurtured the group and seen it grow from strength to strength through his hard work and dedication.
We seek the blessings of the First Lady of the Lexicon Group, the late Kamal Sharma Ma'am, who always had the best interest of the children at heart.
Leading by example are two dynamic individuals who believe in transforming the face of education by equipping young adults to succeed in the real world. Pankaj Sir, the president of the Lexicon Group of Institutes, has always believed in making education inclusive and available to all. The school motto, believe in yourself, is a mantra that he holds dear to his heart.
Neeraj Sir, the vice chairman of the Lexicon Group of Institutes, believes in ideating and innovating to ensure that our students go out as adept citizens of the 21st century. At the helm of all our innovative ventures, we have the focus director of the Lexicon School and the Lexicon Rainbow School, Monisha Ma'am, who believes in a simple but committed goal. No child left behind.
The compassionate Deepti Ma'am strengthens the foundation and looks into molding young minds as the director of the Lexicon Kids.
In his capacity as the CEO of the Lexicon Group of Institutes, the vibrant go-getter, Nasir Sir, ensures that the institute functions with enthusiasm and with well-thought-out goals. As the deputy director, quality assurance, brand standards, and training of the Lexicon Schools and Lexicon Kids, we have the pragmatic and versatile Anjuma, who aims at taking Lexicon to greater heights. She joins us today on this panel as an educational expert, helping us in getting answers to all the questions we have in our minds as students. Welcome, ma'am.
We also have amongst us our wonderful and dynamic heads of our institutions, the soft-spoken, ever-smiling Miss Ruchi Masi, the principal of the Lexicon International School, Kalyani Nagar, the amiable and exuberant Miss Annapurna Lily Bipin Raj, the principal of the Lexicon School, Hadapsar, the creative and compassionate Miss Petronella Eads, vice principal of the Lexicon International School, Wagholi. With such foresighted leaders, it is inevitable.
I will start with Anju, ma'am. I would like to ask you, ma'am, the education infrastructure has gone through major changes as it had to adapt to the global pandemic. But the education institutions throughout the world, including the Lexicon schools, have utilized the technology to make sure that education thrives. What is your opinion on this? Where do you think we are headed in the future?
Thank you, Sanchali, for the question. Well, in my opinion, this technological shift was expected by the education fraternity over a period of time. The pandemic has just accelerated this shift. And that's the reason that Lexicon started their online sessions as early as March 2020 with the senior classes. And we left no stone unturned during pandemic to connect with our children. It was a smooth transition for the Lexiconites from offline to online, ensuring that each and everything is looked into minutely. Coming to the second part of your question, in the coming times, we will eventually move towards more stable and constant blended models of schools and have flipped classrooms. The online education system will open a new world of opportunities now for our children, and they will be able to learn independently and at their own pace, which I feel is a positive side of it. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am, for your opinion. Going ahead with our next question, delivering the quality of education is one thing, and using education to navigate one's future is another. So students, even after their hard work, feel stuck and uncertain about their educational pursuit. So what is your message for such students?
Well, my message to the students and especially to their parents is to be proactive and remain alert in discovering the talents and skills at an early stage, and then strive towards polishing those skills and indulge into vocational trainings of their interest and start establishing themselves. The sooner, the better. In fact, proper career counseling has to be given. Let us not have are unmanned aeroplanes without navigation. So it is better that we start counseling at an age of, say, when the child is in class 6, so proper direction is given.
It's indeed very encouraging, ma'am. My next question is for Lily, ma'am. The pandemic might seem to have limited our opportunities, but it ended up pushing us to realize our full potential and gave us global reach. This means that students are now interacting with their peers globally through online communities or workshops. How prepared are Indian students for this level of reach?
Ma'am, you're on mute.
Thank you, Sanjali. You know, it's really true that the pandemic has affected us, not only physically, mentally, socially, monetarily. It has affected every one of us. But if you look at the education sector, I think, as Anju ma'am said, it's had a very positive impact in a lot of areas, especially in terms of technology. And yes, students are connected globally. They are connected through communities, thanks to social media. There are so many platforms and so many groups where children interact. And I know some of you are already a part of it. I believe that where there is a will, there is a way. And for the students these days, where there is no way, we'll pave one. And that definitely describes all of you who are so technologically savvy and who are always looking forward to connecting. Now, coming to the part about how well equipped our students are. Now, what do you need to be able to connect globally? Technological skills. So let's see what we here have to offer you. Now, in terms of communication skills, I think Sanjali and Harsh are proof or evidence enough of very good communication skills being built up through a lot of activities that happen in school, like the C2Bs, the R&Ds. Of course, the MUN that is coming up, that's also an amazing confidence building activity that is there. And also the ability to be able to connect to others and at the same time, put your view across in a very diplomatic manner. So I definitely feel, you know, with the kind of programs that we have been offering, especially for our senior secondary students, be it the Harvard Youth Program that we had, as well as the Wharton program that is there, then the Masterclass Australia series, those are all platforms that help our children connect across the globe. And we have many more such events coming up. So I'm sure our children here in India are equally equipped to connect with their peers globally.
All right, thank you, ma'am. Going ahead on the same lines, with the pandemic, it is clear how the nature of jobs are changing. So how new professions are surfacing and how new professions require new skills. So students across the country are worried if the current curriculum will be effective for the evolved economy. Is this a relevant fear? And what is your opinion?
Okay. Thank you, Harsh. Yes, definitely the nature of jobs are changing. You see us as teachers, instead of being in the classroom, we are here connecting with you virtually. And so many professions. I mean, to me, I think as of now, even if you look at the medical profession, the kind of the sea of change that has been brought about, not only because of the pandemic, but because of evolving technology. If you see the diagnostics, drug delivery, there is a sea of change that is being brought about. So when we see this kind of a change, then your question was very relevant about how about the curriculum? The curriculum is just a launch pad. The curriculum is a launch pad which is preparing you to land safely into your lives. And here at Lexicon, we make that landing very smooth. We make it smooth by ensuring that the curriculum is a holistic curriculum. It is not that we are giving emphasis only on academics. Yes, academics does form a major part, a major chunk of the curriculum. But when you look at the whole picture, then we have activities which are meant to help children grow, you know, intellectually, to help them grow psychologically, to ensure that the mental health and mental balance of the children is well met with. A lot of activities which help you connect with your peers, because collaboration is a key word. I mean, even if you're looking at starting up a company, you still need to work on your collaborative skills about critical thinking, problem anticipation, problem solving. These are very, very well integrated into the curriculum here at Lexicon. Now, if I look at problem solving at your age, I did not know anything about research and development, except that there is a big research and development facility of the Army that is over here in Diggi. That's about it. But see, you know what it is to look into journals, to refer to other papers, to be able to write an article of your own. My, these are the kind of skills that children would dream of. So if students nowadays are worried whether the curriculum per se would help them face their future, you can definitely tell them, be assured, you're at the right place, and you would sail through life. Just not sail, okay, excel in life, because that's what we train our children here at Lexicon for.
Thank you, Lily.
Thank you, Harsh.
Ruchi ma'am, I would like to ask, many students are considering homeschooling as they find it a substitute for online education. Is there really a difference between these two?
Thank you, Sanchani, for the question. Yeah, there is a difference, a major difference. I would like to say, if you have to check homeschooling versus the school, there are a lot of benefits that one can get once you are at school. You have a trained set of faculty, wherein if you have to consider as parents, the ones who are homeschooling or the caregivers who are giving the homeschooling to the children, they might not be able to, you know, cater to all the subjects and have an expertise over the same which is offered at school. One. Second, a lot of peer interaction happens. A lot of socialization happens when you come to school. There's confidence building that happens at school. You know, you as children, you face competition. You come across so many people who would guide you better. Whereas when you are at home, it's a little bit restricted when it comes to all these opportunities that are offered to children at school. So if you have to ask me, sending children to school is something which is required, not only with the academic benefits that the school has to give, but also gives a wholesome development to each and every child that comes to school. Thank you.
Very rightly said, ma'am. No doubt, schools are the place where we find ourselves socially, emotionally, and intellectually developed. So moving to my next question, Ruchi ma'am, with the change in economy and medical infrastructure, students who want to opt for science and commerce are increasing as they see a higher demand for the subjects. Now, should the schools in India upgrade their curriculum to suit this level of ambition among students?
Thank you, Harsh, for the question. Yes, I would say if you have to look at the robust NCERT curriculum that is offered to the students here, followed by the CBSE school, which looks into it, there is a lot of scope that is given to the commerce and medical related subjects. Skill and vocational based subjects are something which is very rightly highlighted these days, and it has provision already in the CBSE schooling system per se. However, the delivery of these vocational and skills subject is something that the schools need to look at. And if we have to see how lexicon progresses, we have a lot of insight given to children as to how and why a certain subject should be taken and how you progress towards attaining your mastery over the subject. So yes, skill-based subjects, if you have to consider how the economy is changing or how the choices of the children are changing and they're more inclined towards taking a medical or a commerce suite, that is where it lies. So the curriculum itself is equipped. NEP again enforces the same thing. I'd say how the school delivers it to the children is the key to it.
Thank you, Ma'am, for sharing your views. Petronella, ma'am, I would like to ask you, all the students who aim to start preparing for competitive examinations from their 11th class are extremely confused about what they should be doing. What is your message to them?
Well, thank you, Sanchali, for that question. It is often seen that after class 8, students tend to take competitive examinations very lightly. But we all need to understand that these competitive examinations, they not only help develop IQ, logical reasoning, and analytical thinking, and critical thinking skills, or in fact, the very crux on which the lexicon methodologies are based. But they also help build up confidence. I mean, when children want to go out for the entrance tests and all, these are the very foundation for them to build confidence to be able to answer those. Students need to understand that the competitive examinations not only help in providing that foundation for future entrance examinations, but they are a very vital part of the portfolio that they build. Now, these portfolios are very, very important when they're applying, especially to universities or very renowned colleges. For students who plan to go abroad, in fact, these certificates give them an edge over the others, or rather their counterparts. It's also been observed that at many times, students are either aware, are not aware of the opportunities before them, or don't really understand their worth until it's too late. Thus, we at Lexicon have collaborated with a number of organizations, global organizations, in fact, and offer a wide range of competitive examinations and opportunities that have been especially introduced in the recent past for the senior secondary section. So that's definitely somewhere where they need to focus and participate wholeheartedly.
Thank you, ma'am. How has the Lexicon schools made changes in this situation? How should the class 11 students take a few steps ahead moving forward?
Well, to begin with, the Lexicon schools, as we all know, it is based on the CBSE curriculum. The CBSE curriculum itself is designed in such a way that it provides a foundation for students aspiring to attempt a variety of entrance examinations, such as JEE and NEET. Now, at the Lexicon schools, we further provide children with regular career counseling and guidance sessions to help children make an informed decision about the career they want to pursue. We also have a mentorship program wherein and receive guidance as they ponder over difference. Now, apart from offering Lexicon schools, also conduct a leadership with renowned leaders. Students make they guide students onto the right path, so that when students actually have to decide on a career, they know exactly the pros and the cons of the same. We also encourage our students to participate in international competitions from prestigious universities and institutions around the world. And this has proved to be a platform for their growth and development. And definitely the holistic approach is something which enhances their portfolio. In fact, we all are aware of that quote, which said, Jack of all trades and master of none. Okay, but this was something that in the past where we focused on, we would tell children, okay, you need to focus on one, you need to be mastering one. It's not that you just be going ahead and you remain as a jack of all trades. Now, and people used to discourage that kind of a thought process. However, now the whole paradigm has shifted to it becoming the jack of all trades and a master of one. So it means that you need a very diverse outlook. You need to have a holistic approach and definitely mastering one of those. Okay. I hope that's answered your question, Harsh.
Yes, ma'am, it has.
Thank you, ma'am. Wow, I feel duly proud of being a part of the Lexicon School, who aim at giving nothing but the best to its students. Anzu, ma'am, may I ask you, why having subjects relevant to the current career option is important for the high school students?
Good question, Sanchali, and a very important one as well. By making right choices at right time will give meaning to the entire journey of education. I feel it will help in making them survive confidently and give a sense of accomplishment in life by meeting the expectations and then eventually contribute to the national and global economy. Here, I would also like to tell the parents to allow children to take up a career of their own choice. Career choice should not be enforced upon. Today, we have different avenues available. And here at Lexicon, we give a bouquet of subjects to the children to choose upon and study as per their own choice. And I agree with Petronella ma'am, like she said, jack of all trades and master of one. This is what we have to look into. So let us all raise happy children doing well academically and well in life. Thank you.
It is really wonderful to get some valuable advice from you, Anju, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am. Lily, ma'am, I'd like to ask you, the alumni of the Lexicon Schools have reached great universities and colleges for different career pursuits. So would you like to share some insights about them?
Yes, definitely, Harsh. I don't know how many of you are aware, but students from Lexicon have made it to universities across the world, like the University of Iowa, University of Toronto. We have them in Cardiff. We have a student who's going for a summer internship to Harvard. And what I would like to bring to light here is the fact that these students have passed through these very portals where you are studying. And I'm sure you understand that it is the daily, you know, the learnings that come from school that has such an impact on what you do in the future. So beautifully put by Anju ma'am, that the right choices will make your life so happy and meaningful. Because the children have already been here, what it is, they have had exposure to international events. And for most of you who were in school during the ISA, you also had that chance to interact with students across the globe. And that has a very lasting impression on students who want to make it big. Returning back to society is a very, very essential aspect of any student's life. And as students of Lexicon, I think Seva is something that goes down a big way, not only in your curriculum, but your lives as well. So when we talk about the alumni, you also have to look at what sets them apart. What is it that makes them so different from the others? First and foremost, I believe, is the motto, believe in yourself. You know, when you have that faith in you and faith in God, then there is no looking back. And that, I think, is the major deciding factor that has helped these students reach far and wide. Another important aspect is when you learn for life. You're not learning for examinations. You are learning to implement whatever you have learned here at school in your lives. And for that, I think we have all got to be really grateful to our founding directors, our management, who are all always in the process of ensuring that children are prepared for anything and everything that comes about. You know, when I was talking about the curriculum, the most important thing that I did not stress on, which I should have, was about the life skills. I mean, life skills are such an integral part of the curriculum every single day and year. And you realize that you take it for granted most of the times. I mean, what is it? What's so difficult about actually having to do a SWOT analysis? So what? Everybody can do it. But then you realize that that's not it. The fact that you've done an analysis like that for yourself has helped you understand what your challenges are, has helped you work on your weaknesses. And it is from there that you then step forward and understand that, okay, if these are my challenges, what next? That's how children prepare. And I think this preparation starts very early in life. You need to, as I said earlier, believe in yourself, understand what your goals are, and start working towards them. And I'm sure when you are out of school and I meet you 5 years down the line, I can very proudly say that's my student there, having made it to one of the top universities in the world and making yourself, your parents, and your teachers always proud.
Thank you so much, Lily ma'am, for sharing these inspiring insights. Now, there is a common question for all of you.
So the question is, there has always been a tough competition joining the Lexicon school. So what are your views on this, Lily ma'am?
Okay. Harsh, I think a good question, because I remember when I met you and you were joining school, I was so impressed about the fact that you spoke very well. For all of you who are here, I had asked Harsh, so what do you like about Pune? And very sweetly, I think that was class 4, Harsh, where you told me that Pune is a very clean city. And I was very impressed for a child of about 9 years, you know, understanding the need for a clean city was a very, very important aspect for you, which struck me as something, you know, very different from all others, because there are so many things. Okay, I have nice buildings, I have a nice car, my dad has a nice job. That's what children would speak about. But you as a student spoke about having a clean city. So that is what struck me. And that's how I realized that you were coming in. When it was Sanchali, it was her confidence. So we have a team or a pool of students who are here at Lexicon who are amazing to begin with, and we make them excellent along the way. And once you are a part of Lexicon, I don't think you want to leave Lexicon. So that is what makes it so difficult for others to come in, because you are already there. We have a wonderful set of teachers who make learning beautiful, who make learning fun, and who make learning enjoyable for students. And students love to be a part of Lexicon. So since we already have the cream here with us, it is very difficult to, you know, have more of you joining in. That's my take on why it is so competitive to get into Lexicon, Ash.
Thank you so much.
I would like to add here, as to what Lily ma'am has just mentioned, I think if we have to sum it up, we are the best. We are number one here and there's no competition. And to add on to it, see, every school looks into academics and co-curricular activities, etc. But here we make confident individuals. We make our children confident with values, because values is something which is now not to be seen around. So we ensure when we are teaching our children, we are also teaching them values and becoming confident in life. If confidence is there, there's nothing to look back upon.
That's so true, Anjumam. I've also noticed how my peers and how my classmates are so confident. Almost all of them are so good at academics, and all of them have some special talent. And everyone, each of us, I think each of us is a Lexiconite truly, and we all love our school.
Ma'am Petrella, ma'am, what is your take on this opinion?
Yes, I definitely add to that.
to say that what makes us one of the most sought after schools in Pune would be the fact that we believe in 100% participation. That is something where it's very few schools that actually put this in the forefront. I mean, be it in terms of assemblies, we have special assemblies throughout the year where every child from the class participates in the same. We've got the Caterpillar to Butterfly program, which helps in building confidence in children of right from the nursery to class five. We've got the research and development program again, where every student is encouraged to research and to bring their findings to the forefront. So definitely, I mean, being a school which does not focus on just a select few, but in fact gives each and every child equal importance, I think that is something which makes us stand out from the rest, definitely.
Thank you, Pachana ma'am. Ruchi ma'am, would you like to add your views?
Yeah, sure, Sanchali. To sum it up, I'd say if you see what Lily ma'am has shared, what Anju ma'am has shared, and what Petronella ma'am has shared, everything is about the children here at Lexicon. So we ensure that we all activities that we do here or any kind of development that happens here, everything revolves around the children. So we are a child-centric school, I must add, and the teachers have a good connect with the children so that, you know, the children are benefited at every step that we take. So that's my take on it.
Thank you, Ruchi ma'am. Ma'am, it has been an absolute pleasure having you all here this evening. Your positive outlook and zest for life are truly contagious. The insight you have given us have definitely cleared doubts in the mind of many and will help students to take informed choices and decisions.
I now end our session with a vote of thanks. We are grateful to our chairman, Mr. S.B. Sharma, sir, our president, Mr. Pankaj Sharma, sir, our vice chairman, Mr. Neeraj Sharma, sir, our director, Ms. Monisha Sharma, ma'am, and the director of Lexicon Kids, Ms. Deepti Sharma, ma'am, for giving us such wonderful opportunities and initiatives to develop into young, confident individuals.
We will always be grateful to our director, Mrs. Monisha Sharma, ma'am, for leading us onto the path of excellence and innovation. We are further thankful to our CEO, Mr. Nasir Sheikh, sir, for carrying the beacon of enthusiasm at all times and instilling the same in us. We also extend gratitude to Anju Mitra, ma'am, our Deputy Director, Quality Assurance, Brand Standards and Training of the Lexicon School and Lexicon Kids, for taking our time today and being with us here, for guiding us and motivating us to achieve our dreams.
We are also thankful to our school heads and principals, Dr. Annapurna Lily Bipin Raj ma'am, Ruchi Masin ma'am, and Petronella ma'am, for always leading by example and instilling in us the good values of dedication and focus. Thank you so much for being with us here today. No event can be a success without the hard work and preparation put in by our team of experts at the back end, who make sure that we have smooth sailing event.
A big thank you to our valued Lexiconites and our dear viewers. Stay healthy, stay fit, stay happy today and always.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.